Revelation 3 verse 8, the Bible tells us, "I know all the things you do, and I have opened a door for you that no one can close. You have little strength, yet you obey my word and did not deny me." Can you recognize the signs that God is opening new doors for you? How do you know if these signs of a new door are from God? Often when the doors are open, they are in communication with God. When the doors are closed, they did not communicate or were not in agreement. 1 Corinthians 16 verse 9 tells us, "Because a great door for effective work has opened to me, and there are many who oppose me." Life is full of changes. God opens doors and God closes doors as we go through life. Psalms 37 verse 23 tells us, "The Lord directs the steps of the godly. He delights in every detail of their lives." Most of the time, we want God to open doors for us. However, God wants us to open doors for Him to eat with us. In Revelation 3 verse 20, we see, "Here I am, I stand at the door and knocking. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in and eat with that person and there with me." God is knocking. He is waiting for us to open the door for Him. Are you letting God in when He's knocking? The key is knowing how to discern if an opportunity is really an open door from God. Just because an opportunity presents itself and it looks appealing does not necessarily mean it is from God. The Bible gives us some principles to help us understand if an open door or opportunity is really from God. The door that God opens will never contradict His word. God will not lead you towards an opportunity that contradicts what He clearly says in His word. Nor will He open a door that will require personal compromise or disobedience in order for you to enter. Isaiah 22 verse 22 tells us, "I will place on His shoulder the key to the house of David. What He opens, no one can shut, and what He shuts, no one can open." The door that God opens will be accompanied by confirmations. Matthew 18 verse 15 through 16 tells us, "Moreover, if your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he hears you, you have gained your brother. But if he will not hear, take with you one or two more, that by the mouth of two or three witnesses, every word may be established." The door God opens will require you to depend on Him. God is not going to give us something that will separate us from Him or make us believe we no longer need Him. He is a God of relationship and a God who insists upon being first in our lives. Matthew 6 verse 33 tells us to seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and He will give you everything you need. Many times an open door from God is one that allows our faith to be stretched and strengthened. God's objective for us is to grow in faith and to be like Christ. It blesses others when we do so. This brings glory to God. Proverbs 11 verse 25 says, "Whoever brings blessing will be enriched, and one who waters will himself be watered." The signs that God is opening a door should not be full of confusion. Though you may face resistance here and there from the enemy, you can still have peace. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 tells us, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." God is opening new doors that can be confirmed through prayer. The more you are connected to God in prayer, the easier it will be to hear His voice with precision. Psalms 32 verse 8 through 9, the Bible tells us, "I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eye upon you. Be not like a horse or a mule without understanding, which must be curbed with bait and bridle, or it will not stay near you." Tonight we are going to pray for God to open a new door for us. In John 10 verse 7, the Bible tells us, "Then Jesus said to them, most assuredly I say to you, I am the door of the sheep." Jesus is the door that we must enter to get comfort, peace, rest, protection, and salvation. Jesus has the power to open the doors that have been shut by the enemy, and also has the power to shut any doors that have been opened against us. That is why He says nothing that is difficult for Him to do. When He tells you the doors are opening for you, keep thanking God, because God has done great things. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I come to you in the name of my Lord Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, I pray that you will quicken me to hear my Heavenly Father's voice and lead me in prayer tonight. Heavenly Father, I bow and worship you. I come to you with praise, with thanksgiving. I come to you with humility and humbleness, in fear and trembling, and in gratitude, in love, and through the precious blood of your Son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus, thank you for who you are and what you did for me at the cross. I put my eyes on you, Jesus. I worship you, I honor you, I glorify you. You are my everything. Thank you, Jesus, that you are my Savior, my Deliverer, my Baptizer, my Healer, spiritually, physically, mentally, emotionally, and financially. My eyes are on you. I am reaching out to touch you. Just like the woman with the issue of blood, she knew if she could push her way through the crowd and touch you, that your power will flow. Jesus, here I am tonight reaching out to you to touch you. Lord, open the doors of heavenly blessings and breakthrough upon my life, my ministry, my business, my profession, my health, my income, and relationships in the mighty name of Jesus. I cut off by the Holy Ghost fire every satanic force, every demonic blockage, every remote control, every gadget and monitoring device militating against my open doors. No man or devil can shut the doors before me and open heaven over my life in Jesus' name. I decree and declare, proclaim that the doors of heavenly treasures are open permanently to me in Jesus' name. I claim perpetual open heaven over my life, my family, my ministry, my workplace, and everything I do. Lord, open the floodgates of heaven and rain of blessing upon me as angels ascend and descend unto me in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus Christ, I seal all back doors and windows that give the enemy access into my blessings or divine treasures. I cancel, reverse, neutralize, reject, and counter any demonic decrees, any spells, any ordinances, any enchantment, any plans, any ploy or plot and pronouncement against my open doors. I declare and decree that my open door of blessings, divine favors, and open heavens remain permanent in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus Christ, I come in every demonic doorway designed to cut away my blessings, to burn to ashes by Holy Ghost fire. Lord, because of your open door blessing over my life, bypass policies, politics, protocols, procedures, process, and routines to favor me in Jesus' name. I decree and I declare, I pronounce and proclaim that every closed door favor by the devil, familiar spirit, witchcraft, and marine spirit be opened by Holy Ghost fire tonight in Jesus' mighty name. I shattered, I scattered, and set ablaze by Holy Ghost fire every satanic doors, brass doors, cursed ancestral doors, iron and limitation doors closed against my progress and my family in Jesus' name. I consume by Holy Ghost fire all roadblocks, all barricades, all hindrances, any chains, any iron bars, and padlock at the entrance of my open door in the mighty name of Jesus. I walk through destiny promotion open doors designed by the Holy Ghost and sealed by fire any cursed demonic doors in Jesus' name. Father, station your warring angels of fire to mend my open doors and divine favor in Jesus' name. Let the angelic watchers, prosperity, and worshiping angels guard and guide my open doors tonight continuously in the name of Jesus. Lord, open wide all doors you have ordained and close permanently all hell doors and let me discern the difference in Jesus' name. Lord Jesus, burn to ashes all demonic thrones, any authorities and dominions sitting at the door of my blessings in Jesus' name. Lord, open the door of the spirit of my life in Christ Jesus and set me from the door of the shadow of death in Jesus' name. I sprinkle the protective blood of Jesus Christ on every doorpost of my house, office, or workplace. Lord Jesus Christ, I open the door of my heart to you and cut off the enemy's access by Holy Ghost fire. Father, your words say, lift up your heads, O ye gates, and ye be lifted up, ye everlasting doors. And the King of Glory shall come in. Lord, I ask to restore all that I have lost as a result of ignorance, witchcraft, and closed doors by the enemy. As I open the door of my house, I shall receive good news from expected personality in the name of Jesus. As I open my door, let every bad spirit associated with me depart from me in Jesus' name. As I open my door, let success and promotion be attached to my life in the name of Jesus. As I open my door of my workplace, the power of God shall destroy every enemy of progress in Jesus' name. As I open my door by faith, I declare I shall enjoy the favor of God and all men all day of my life in Jesus' name. As I open my door, my God shall supply all my needs according to his glory in Christ Jesus. As I open my door, I shake out all evil inheritance and curses troubling my life in the name of Jesus. As I open my door, let everything that represents sorrow, setback, and stagnation, shame come out of my life tonight in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, blood of Jesus Christ, purge and clear obstacles away from my finances in the mighty name of Jesus. O Lord, open by fire every door shut against my prosperity in Jesus' name. The divine keys to open my financial breakthrough doors I release by fire in Jesus' name. Let the fire of God break the witchcraft house storing my financial blessing tonight in Jesus' name. Any evil personality tying down the works of my hand, catch fire in Jesus' name. my financial destiny, where are you? Arise and locate me tonight in Jesus' mighty name. I release financial open doors and happiness in every area of my life in the name of Jesus. Every evil wind delegated to blow away, the harvest of my efforts dry up and backfire to senders in Jesus' name. All my enemies, hear the word of the Lord. You must surrender in shame in Jesus' name. Altar of poverty is signed against my prosperity. I set you ablaze tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. I break and loose myself from every collective curse and setback in Jesus' name. Anyone has taken anything from me with the intention to harm me be disgraced tonight in Jesus' name. All doors of goodness that have been closed against me, I command it to open today in Jesus' name. I curse every trace of poverty in my life in Jesus' name. Fire of God, locate and open every closed door against my finances in Jesus' name. Every roadblock on my way to achievement break and scattered by fire in Jesus' name. Every strong man attacking me at the edge of breakthrough fall down and die in Jesus' name. I refuse to enter through a door that God is preventing me to enter tonight in Jesus' name. Every door of my destiny that has been closed be forever open unto me in Jesus' name. I declare all around breakthrough and freedom in my life in the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise and intervene my situation tonight in Jesus' mighty name. I declare that every impossible situation possible tonight in Jesus' name. I receive the keys to open every closed doors in every area of my life in Jesus' mighty name. Oh Lord, let my life disgrace every satanic power against me in Jesus' name. Let all my problems pass through this door today in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, command solution to every difficult situation in my life tonight in the name of Jesus. God of heaven, I pray that I see doors and see heaven be open. Drip down, O heavens, from above, and let the clouds pour down righteousness. Let the earth be opened up. Let salvation bear fruits and righteousness spring up with it. I pray for black doors to be open, and I thank you in advance for the breakthrough that you are going to give me. Heavenly Father, we ask that you open your heavens and come down. Father, we pray that you reach down from heavens and save us from those who try to persecute us. We will praise your name and we will sing a new song to you. Lord, we praise your name because you are the one who helps us in our battles. We pray that your will for us in heaven aligns with our life here on earth. Lord, I thank you for who you are and your divine power. I pray that just as you sent your angels to open the gates of the prisons, you open doors in my life. I pray that you open the heavens so that I can receive my breakthrough here on earth. I thank you for opening doors for me and letting heaven rain down on me tonight. Lord, I look to you right now. Your word says that you are the door of the ship. So Father, we place our trust in you because you will open doors for us that are closed. I pray for your divine guidance through these doors and thank you for opening them. With you, there is always a way. But alone we will remain stagnant. Thank you for being the eternal door. Oh Lord, a day in your court is better than 1,000 outside. I pray, Heavenly Father, that I have divine access to your spiritual realm. Let the doors of heaven be open. I would rather stand at the threshold of the house of my God than dwell in the tents of wickedness. Lord, close all doors of evil over my life and open doors of heaven in alignment with your will, Father, in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, thank you for always seeing me and my needs. Your words tells me that when I ask, it will be given to me, and what I seek, I will find. For when I ask you, I must believe that I will receive it. What I seek shall be found. When I knock, you answer. So Father, I praise you for being the door that is always open. Thank you. Righteous God, keep me holy and true like you have been. I declare that the doors you have opened, no one will shut. And the doors you have closed, no one will open. I declare your will over my life and the life of those I come in contact with. I thank you for the open doors you have placed before me, Father, that no one can shut. But you see that in my natural state, I have little power. It is you who has the ultimate authority. You see that I have kept your word and have not denied your name. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray tonight. To God be all the glory. Amen.